Hey y'all, it's your girl Erica Vane, back again with another Love Victor video. And in this video, we are giving you the predictions for season 3. Let's get into it. All right, y'all, to round out our coverage of Love Victor, here is what we are thinking is most likely to happen in season 3. Again, major shout outs to our television critic, Emily Powell, who has written this breakdown with predictions as well as done all of our full coverage of Love Victor on ericavane.com. If you want to learn more about the series, get a little bit more of her insights, you can go over to ericavane.com and check out her articles that are written out. Link will be in the description box below. Now, first of all, who is our boy running to? Really? Victor was told to imagine the person he wanted to spend the rest of his life with, and then he just took off running. Where is he going? Okay, hear me out. But I think he's going to Raheem's. It would make sense if he's running to apologize to Benji. He and Benji have been in an established relationship. He literally says his type was Benji, but I think it's a red herring. Raheem and Victor had a whole establishing episode, a whole romantic kiss, and Raheem said that if Victor ever figured himself out, he knew where he lived. We see Victor map into a house in the next scene. Why would Victor need a GPS to get from Mia's house to Benji's? They've been dating for nearly a year now. He should know how to get there by now. But Raheem, he'd need a GPS to get there. Their relationship will be cute, but I can't see it lasting more than a season. Moving on, we're worried about Mia, y'all. She never really made up with Victor, and we saw her pushing Lake away near the end of season 2. That means that she has no one to turn to but Andrew as she runs away from home and towards the mother who abandoned her. She effectively is isolating herself, which means she won't have anyone to turn to if this reunion goes south. Here's how I think it's going to go down. Mia's mom is going to start off seeming like a cool person, probably more down to earth than her rich father, but that's going to change. She reached out because she wanted something from Mia, and Mia will not realize that until she's completely alone with no one to rely on but her mother. It'll take some time, but by the end of season 3, she will realize her mistake and begin mending bridges with her friends back home. I'm less sure what will happen with her father. He's made so many parenting mistakes. Speaking of parenting mistakes, Isabel and Armando are getting back together. I think they'll actually make it this time. They've grown so much as people over season 2, and they still found their way back to each other. That's love. Yes, love is in the air. Pilar and Felix have kissed at the end of season 2, and by season 3, they will be dating. It'll be a relationship they both need. Lake got Felix out of his shell, but he needs someone who can relate to him. Someone who stays up all night watching quiz shows or talking on his front stoop. And it looks like Lake will be taken away. We also saw Lucy asking Lake out for champagne at the end of season 2. That's a date. I don't know if Lake knows that it's a date, but I'm excited to see where it goes. I'm doubly excited because it means that we'll probably be getting some bisexual representation in season 3. Bisexuality is underrepresented in media, and we're crossing our fingers and hoping that this will be good. As for the overarching themes that season 3 might add, we suspect that it will build upon the themes of mental health season 2 brought forth. This storyline will mostly revolve around Mia and her increasing isolation and Felix like it did in season 2. But I suspect Victor will also have a mental health crisis as he spirals out of one relationship and into another. I also think that season 3 will deal with the fluidity of sexuality. This show has mentioned several times that sexuality is fluid, but has not yet shown it in its characters. However, now we have Lake, who may be bisexual, and Lucy, who dated Andrew at the beginning of season 2, but now is definitely showing interest in women. Season 3 will definitely bring the drama, and we cannot wait to see it. We don't want to wait a whole year, but I guess we must. You can tide yourself over by rewatching season 2 currently streaming on Hulu, and let us know what you think. What are you expecting for season 3? Drop down in the comment section down below and let us know. Again, major shout outs to Emily Powell, our television critic, who is breaking down Love Victor, all things Love Victor, right on ericavane.com. You can also head over to her articles and post a comment there. Thanks so much for watching. If you miss any of our Love Victor coverage, you can check out our video playlist right here. And if you're looking for something new to watch, we got 2 suggestions for you on screen right now, right here. We'll see you in the next one. Bye!